One time my niece asked me like, "Uncle, what do you do?" And I was like, "Fuck, how do I explain this to her?" And I think I said something like, I feel like I am an alien in this world. And I approach every single human as if they were its own civilization, its own customs. They all wake up different, have different breakfasts and like all these things. And like, I feel like each of them have an accumulation of life to them. And I think that is one of the tactics that you could say is that I approach people, things, objects, art, anything that my senses can perceive, as well as ideas and concepts that can come out of them, with a desire to understand. Even though I say this doesn't come from a desire place, but I think it's to be understanding more than to want to understand, but to be understanding. And I think that also the way that I phrase that is like to be, no? Estar, ser, to be. And to be understanding, that is one of the main tactics that I use.
Estuvimos ahí como por media hora y por un momento olvidé todo el caos porque vi el cielo más hermoso que había visto en toda mi vida. Estábamos en el medio de ningún lugar, no había luces alrededor y cuando mirabas el cielo podías ver toda la Vía Láctea. Y por primera vez en mi vida entendí por qué le decían la Vía Láctea. Vi las estrellas, veía la osa mayor, la osa menor. No se veía la luna esa noche, pero sí se veían las estrellas más brillantes que jamás había visto en toda mi vida.
It starts as a simple image that before, I guess, as I worked in video, was to like recreate that image and try to like bring it to life and document it in that form. And then it just like that, you know, it's gone. And I think now I see an image and sometimes I don't even know what it is. Sometimes I think it's the image that you can take out of an experience, even though it's not like representational of, it's not representational of the thing that I saw in my head sometimes. And as I move forward, I feel like my drive is this desire of relearning how to read. It's like something that I just was thinking about very recently, where I have these very, very clear memories of me growing up as a kid, learning like Spanish, no? And like A, B, C, or like A, E, I, O, U. And like me seeing things in that moment and not understanding what it meant, right? It was just things that are in the world. And these icons, which were little, eventually we called letters, for me, they had no meaning. And I think that is what is driving now. It's like, I would like to make word that it's that, where it's a very hard for you to understand the thing that you're seeing and kind of like live without its meaning, if that makes any sense. That kind of like sense of like one can create its own meaning. But of course, you know, like I don't feel like I am making meaningless work. I think it's something for me very much connected to like how language shapes my understanding of reality or like my surroundings. And this language doesn't have to be just written or spoken. It can be visual in like how buildings are made, how you enter a space, how time is received. Like, I think that aspect of being an unknown and like unlearned space of language, I think I would love to like translate that into like other things. like be it moving images or sculptural objects and performance. And I think that's really fascinating because I think like art allows a lot of that. As my recent entry into the film world apparently does not. Like, if I put enough time into observing this rock or this piece of old popcorn, it would reveal things to you that you probably never thought about because you didn't never put that kind of like time and effort into thinking about it or just like holding it for a long time. Sometimes I call myself a filmmaker, sometimes I'm not. I feel like there's an industry attached to like filmmaking, you know, and I hate it. No, hate is such a strong word. I'm like, I just don't care for it. I think that if I am able to embrace that aspect of my practice of like, maybe I am, but then make objects and still call them like, oh yeah, there's still a film. I think that's something that is interesting. I guess to speak to these ideas of intuition and instinct when talking about decision making in my art, I like to go back and think about this moment that I had when I went to Mexico City. I took my camera gear and like audio. I was supposed to like document some musical performance. And I stayed with a friend of mine that I've known for like more than half my life, which she just passed away during COVID. And there's something that happened in that night where I just hanging out with a bunch of people that I didn't know. And it was like really like 3 a.m. or something like that. And I had my camera and everything, and we're starting to get to know each other. And I asked one of them, like, what do you do? And then he like looks at me and says, like, I'm an opera singer. And I was like, oh, what are you singing right now? He's like, oh, well, I'm practicing like a Don Quixote song. And I was like, want to make a video?
Que la terre a tant tourné vous s'enfonça, je lui t'aime, je repense.
Everyone that was in the room was so helpful and like ready to go, because I think it was one of those moments of like intuition, instinct, where I was like, I got this sound, I got this camera, I got this thing, this person likes film, I got my friend that's gonna like write with me and like help me out. And then like just this beautiful one shot, single shot opera performance in the hallway of my friend's apartment just came about. This other moment that I had in my life where I was just sitting there and the hummingbird lands in my hand, just stood at it. You could have just grabbed it, but it's just this, you just putting your hand out. And sometimes these moments of synchronization happen. And I think that's something that drives a lot of my work, these ecstatic moments. And most of them, I can't even share them, which is the failure of my practice, I guess. And yeah, I've been lucky enough to be able to share some of them. And most of them, I'll die with them.